Good morning. I'm Austin Brigden. Welcome back to the Library Garden. The garden's a little tired. Things can feel a little chaotic this time of year, but there's a lot going on. Let's take a look. Squash varies a bit, but with small squash like this, what you want to look for is that the rind has gotten hard, and that the color's good. So with your typical acorn squash, it would be dark green. You'd look for the bottom to be orange. But with these, since they're orange, you just look for a consistent color all around. When you're ready to cut it, give it a good amount of stem, up to like 2 inches, and go ahead and cut a nice clean cut. In a subsequent episode, we'll talk about how you can save seed from these. Here's Austin, ready to talk about corn. This is a popcorn, Dakota Black, bred in the Dakotas, so it's great for a short season. With sweet corn, you'd have picked it green, but this is popcorn, so you leave it to dry out on the stalk. Even sometimes until the entire plant is brown, if you have time, but the ears are brown, and that's good enough for us. So you'll want to just find a brown stalk, feels nice and firm. Snap it right off the stalk. Now I've got a few here that we're gonna go unwrap. Hopefully they look as good inside. Sometimes you don't even need to unwrap them to see they're bad. I can tell that somebody's been at this one. Now I'm no wildlife scientist, but first I thought it was a nutria, then I thought it was a possum, but now I'd be willing to bet anything that it's a squirrel. And if there are any squirrels watching at home or live now from the trees, please leave our corn alone. Now we're gonna go unwrap these. I'm really excited to unwrap these. I don't know what we're gonna get, but you know, I sure wish Jeremy were here. He really loves popcorn. I haven't seen him in a while. Look at that color. Now these range from reddish to a deep black, reddish black, and most of them have slightly pointed kernels. That's a real hallmark of this type. These are gonna be great for popping, but they're also just beautiful to have around the house. Now, once you harvest these, take them inside to a cool, dry room without a lot of sunlight. Lay them out side by side on a sheet or a piece of newspaper and leave them for a couple of weeks. Now, by then, the kernels should start to loosen and fall off. You can take a few and test them in the microwave. If they don't pop, wait another week and try again. Keep repeating that until they do. If things get popping, then you're gonna put them in an airtight container and pop at your leisure. Thank you for joining us again in the Library Garden. Seed checkouts are now closed for this season. If you happen to save any easy save crops, you can return them during drive-through hours, just in a Ziploc bag or paper sack, clearly labeled with the variety. One more thing I'd like to mention before I go. Friends, I have a confession to make. I gave you some bad information in a previous episode. I told you that this tomato was a Juan Flamé. It's not. It's a Rose de Bern. Thanks to Hillary and all our friends at the Lower Columbia School Gardens for pointing out my mistake and for the plant. I feel so much better. Doesn't it always feel good to set the record straight? Well, that about does it for me today. I'm gonna go enjoy my Juan Rose de Bern. I'm Austin Brigden. I've gotta grow, but I'll seed you later in the Longview Library Garden.